Hi everybody, it's Mr. Parrish from Spring Bank Media Arts. And for this lesson, I want to do a small demonstration on once you've captured your video, how do you adjust things to make them look black and white and do as they do in those cool old film noir movies and get those great looking rich black and white tones. And it's surprising, it just takes a few simple steps, and in this lesson, I'm going to show you how. So if you take a look at what I'm doing is, I have a clip that I've already imported, and I used an example that was kind of low dramatic light, strong shadow, and nothing really goes on in the scene, but you'll see that it's pretty easy to edit. So the first thing we want to do is go up to our effects tab up here, and we want to look at video filters. Now, let me say this while we're doing it. There are several different ways to achieve the same goal, and the one I'm going to show you might work for you. If you have a different way around it, or you discover a way you like better, that's fine. But you have to ultimately know that there's a few things that we're looking for. So the first thing I'm going to do is we're going to go down to the Image Control tab, and there's the main things we're going to adjust are going to be found within this folder. Desaturate is going to be the first one we add, and we're going to drag that down, and we simply pop it on the clip. And you'll see over here that my clip has gone black and white. Now, it looks pretty good, but we're going to enhance it just to make it a little bit more intense, a little bit better. To do that, we're also going to adjust brightness and contrast. I'm going to pull that down and let it go. And if I double click the clip, you'll see that here in my viewer, if I go under filters, you'll see that now I have some sliders. And this is where we're going to adjust the clip to make it look even better. So we're going to keep our desaturate full. You can see if I slide it, color starts to get back, or I even oversaturate. But we're going to leave that totally grayscale, no color in it whatsoever. Now we can adjust our brightness. We can start to say, oh, maybe do I want to pop it up a little bit? And I can strengthen that contrast as a balance. Now I realize my bad on when I was doing the light. I had it aimed a little bit lower than I wanted to, and I didn't quite get the eyes as bright as I wanted. But we're going to make do for the example, looking at nice dark shadows, making it dramatic. Now my goal is not to go so black that I crush everything, and you can see areas here that are overexposed and underexposed, either too white or too black. So it's finding a nice balance. So we add a little bit of drama, you don't want to go too bright or too dark, and I'm happy with that. Here's our original clip, and here's the one that we have altered. Now another thing you can look at is you can look at levels, and I'm going to drag the levels down, and you'll see that the levels again allow you to adjust a very similar thing. And you can see I can adjust just the reds, blues, greens, etc., and I can adjust the brightness of that. We're going to do our entire RGB. Again, you can see the tolerance from pure gray to maximum value. Again, another gamma slider. I'm going to increase our input tolerance, or excuse me, decrease our input tolerance. So here we are finished. I'm just going to run a render. It's okay, it hasn't been saved. And poof, through the magic of editing, it's done. So you're going to use this in your film noir project to get the best dark and light values that you can get. Remembering the grays, don't wash out the blacks. Try to just touch on black and touch on white and have this nice rich range of grays in the middle, and I think you'll find that you have the best looking picture you can get for your film noir. All right, thank you.